The programs that have suddenly sort of broken through and I think have kind of gained general, sort of penetration into society and that we all sort of now are familiar with. I've heard those referred to as generative AI. Is that right? Like ChatGPT and all these other the large language learning models. Have I thrown in one more L? Do you think you could talk very briefly just about the different kinds of AI models that maybe not everyone have heard of by this point?
So let's talk about generative AI. So if you think about, if I say the phrase, hi, how are you? I am, in that pause, your mind probably filled in some plausible, completion for that. I am fine, or I'm doing okay, or whatever that is. So there are these patterns of expression that become sort of common and intuitive. And these patterns of expression, when you look at, forums on the internet, or you look at Wikipedia or scientific papers, these patterns of expressions kind of occur over and over. So imagine doing that kind of completion, but now imagine doing it for every entry in Wikipedia, all of Wikipedia, that kind of next word completion. Now take a lot of scientific research papers and imagine being able to do that very accurate next word completion on a random scientific research paper that I put in front of you. This is how these models are trained, to do this next word completion over large, diverse corpora of data, from internet to scientific papers, even to code. And so inherent in that training is trying to do some kind of characterization or analysis of the context of the query, everything that came before, hi, how are you, I am. So some analysis of sequences like that, and then a generation of the completion. Right, so it's doing in technical terms, this is called encoding, doing that kind of featureization of a sequence of tokens or text, words, code, etc., and then generating a completion. Now it's trained to do these kind of single word completions, but what you find is when you actually use them, they can do much longer completions, and they generate very plausible document summaries or code functions in code. And different generations of these kind of sequences of tokens, words, code, images, however you're using these models. That's generative AI.